is no way to keep from becoming a zombie. We were coming to Comic-Con and walking around, and there were a lot of zombie fighters at Comic-Con. You saw them in their battle-worn gear with the blood on their faces and hands. You've got to wash your hands. You've got to clean your face. Like, this is no way to keep from becoming a zombie. I thought, you know what? Maybe there is some advice out there about how do you keep from becoming a zombie? And so what we're looking at is how infectious diseases are portrayed in comic books and popular media. So public health is actually a really broad field. It is really looking at how patterns of our environment, of behaviors, of belief, shape our health outcomes. The difference between that and medicine, for example, is we're looking at the population as a whole and what are influences on a large group of people rather than what is the influence on that one individual patient. We're going through like grayscale and zombies and legacy virus and Batman contagion. And our goal really is to connect the fiction to the science and really help build better ways of using infectious disease in art. Because not only does our fears, our feelings about infectious disease influence how we write that art, but those stories we tell can help change our perception of disease in real life, change our perception of those who have the disease and how we treat them. It can help make it more understandable. I truly love it. It is challenging work, it's difficult work, but every day you know that the world is safer. Somebody's life is better for the work that you've done each day. The reward is there at the end.